Hi guys, it's story time. So, as you might have guessed by the title of this video, my boyfriend is a butt head. And he decided that he was going to break up with me 2 weeks. 2 weeks after my foot was amputated. Why? So the story goes that the boyfriend, he had been investigating the church for a little while. Because like when we first got together, I told him and like warned him. I'm like, you know, like the church stuff might come in between us because I am LDS or a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and he is not. And where that gets in the way is if you want to have a temple covenant marriage. Now, I wanted that. I really did. But you can't have that if he's not willing to be a member of the church. So we were together for about 4.5 months before I kind of like just sat down with him and I was like, look, bud, this is where my life is going. And then kind of like asking him if he was coming with me. And all he did was just like basically storm out of my house, like super freaking furious. And yeah. So boyfriend storms out of my house, super freaking furious. This was like, like 2-ish weeks ago, I think. Yeah. Like a week or so ago. And then, and then last Sunday, he comes to get hit some of his stuff that was still at the house. Some of his like expensive stuff. And he threw a beaded lizard that only had one foot, like me, that I made him, at me. After he had grabbed all his stuff, he came back and threw the little lizard at me. And I was like, what the heck? You know, like, he was just a really big butthead. He's a big butthead about how he handled everything, honestly. So after he had thrown the lizard at me, like a day later, he calls me up and he's like, yo, I want to be apologetic and like say sorry and stuff. And so I was like, okay, like you can say sorry, but, and like he wanted to get me back and I was still pretty mad at this point, that he like tried to break up with me in the first place. So what happened was is he came over and apologized. And, I mean, that was good that he did that in person, and there was finally a little bit of communication there. And then we talked on the phone a couple of days during this week. And so he kept saying when we were on the phone this week, like, I'm gonna go to church. He's like, I read the whole Book of Mormon. Like, you know, like, things look good. And then today he sends me this big long text that's like, I lied about reading the whole Book of Mormon, blah, 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 blah. I was only interested in the church because of you. And I was just like, really? Really? Yeah. So that's kind of what happened because like, and then he got like super pissed off because his life just isn't in the life trajectory that mine is. And he felt like the church wasn't the right thing for him right now. And that's always sad when that happens like to you as a missionary. And, but I mean like, this is just a sad, unfortunate end to a relationship that brought me some joy. He got me out of the house a couple times and I was laughing again, something that I hadn't done in a long time because of the CRPS, and I hadn't really seen any friends for a while. So it was really, really good for me to have someone around, to be social with. Eventually things did get a bit toxic, especially when he just like retaliated without talking to me, basically. And I had no idea if he was like targeting the amputation itself, or if he was just targeting the, like, he didn't want to tell his parents about the fact that he was investigating the church, which, by the way, he eventually did, but he did it in anger. And I honestly think what he told his parents was just like, I broke over there because she wants me to get baptized and I'm not going to get baptized. But the truth was, I wanted to see some improvement in his engagement with the church. So that's what I was trying to get at. And I'm like, okay, if there's no improvement with your engagement in the church, like, why are we wasting our time for the next 16 months? Because I'm just going to go to a YSA ward anyway. So, yeah. And then it kind of turned into a big ugly mess. He's apologetic this week, and so I'm like, okay, I will let you go to church. And, like, we'll see if you're going for the right reasons. Well, today rolls around, Sunday. And, yeah, he didn't go to church. He's just like, I lied about everything. I'm just like, what the crap, man? It hurt. It hurt a lot. So, fact of the matter is, he didn't handle his emotions well. Like, even when I was in the hospital, there was, like, almost 3 days where he literally, like, didn't even text me. And I was like, what the honk? Like, what the heck? How do you just go, like, 3 days without texting your girlfriend when she's in the hospital? I think in some ways I might have been, like, too pushy on the church thing, but at the same time, not really, because, like, that's what's super, super important to me, is the church and our beliefs and having someone that I can have this covenant marriage with, which is a promise between me, the other person, and God, and it's a forever marriage. Like, we believe that it lasts beyond until death do you part. We believe it's for eternity. And I definitely want my husband to be there with me for eternity. Oh, by the way, the reason I'm filming in this position is because my leg hurts like crazy today, and that's probably a combination of just, like, being kind of stressed out and, like, all my emotions are just going all over the place today. But anyway, the phantom limb pain has been pretty bad today, so I decided to just lay down, elevate the foot, and stick the camera on my laptop and record the video. There was one point where right after he threw the lizard at me last week, he called me up like that same night at like midnight, and okay, this is bad behavior on my part, but I'm gonna tell you what happened because it's funny. So, I pick up the phone, and I'm like, now you want to talk to me? Now that you, like after you, like, came into my house, like a tyrant, threw things at me, and now you want to talk to me? Like, like, I was just so annoyed. So, yeah, I kind of just, like, let it rip and yelled at him at midnight. Which wasn't very nice of me, but it's like, yeah, like, if you do get me to a point that I'm pretty angry, it's like, you're gonna get yelled at. Especially if you, like, don't respect my boundaries and you keep trying to overstep them, or if, like, I don't know, or if you keep trying to, like, maneuver your way around my boundaries, it's like, you're gonna get the fury of hell from this woman. Just saying. Just saying.